I'm totally crafty. And I'm totally crazy. And I'm totally Lanie K.
Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Lanie K here. Today we are making a Decoden container. So I'm so happy with how this turned out. And this is a full voiceover video. This is my first Decoden, so I'm actually really, really happy with how it turned out. This is a clay tutorial, so you don't need fake whipped cream for you people that out there that can't get silicone or fake whipped cream, whatever. So you just need some clay to make this. So you're going to want to pick your colour of clay. I'm using white, but you could use whatever colour. You could use pink. You're going to want cabochons. I'm using two that are in the front, but you can use any. I'm also using a container, which some of the cabochons were in. You're going to want eyeshadow if you want to colour your whipped cream because you don't have coloured clay. You're going to want a pencil and a spoon, and I didn't show the spoon in the materials you're going to need, but I did use a spoon. You're going to need a bowl, two bowls, one with water and one without. I know there are some water remains in the yellow bowl, but yeah. You're also going to need a little Ziploc baggie and a pair of scissors. And this is used as your piping bag. And if you also want to have a little piping tip, you can also do that as well. So you're going to want to start with your bowl without any water. And I know there is a little bit of water in there, but that wasn't meant to happen. You're going to want to sprinkle a little bit of clay in. Not sprinkle, but you know what I mean. You're going to want to pour some water in and then start mixing it with your pencil. I started using a pencil, but I found it easier with a spoon, so I swapped to a spoon a little afterwards. Yeah, I swapped right there. Okay, so I pretty much just kept mixing, and I mixed for ages, and I was adding more water, adding more clay, and it just was a very, very long process getting the right mix. You want a kind of sloppy mixture, but not super sloppy that it will come falling off the sides. So you pretty much want just a nice mixture, maybe like a cake batter mixture, sort of a mixture like that. So I was mixing for a very long time, as you can see. So I'm still mixing. Okay, so here it is completed. And I know it is a little bit gluggy, but that all didn't really matter once I flattened it out on the actual container anyway. So do not worry about that. So I'm pretty happy with how that turned out. I know the bowl is kind of messy now, but I'm happy. You can also use your two utensils to get any like trash clay, I'm going to call it. So now you're going to want to start by getting your bowl and putting in your whipped cream. This took me ages, and yeah, it took me ages to get it all in, and it was really hard to film. I hope you guys can understand. Pretty much all you have to do is just, as I showed you there, just get a bit and then kind of dump it in the bag and keep doing that until you have all of it in. And I'm going to cut the recording now so you don't have to watch me filling the entire thing, because this took like 3 minutes. And I know that doesn't sound like a long time, but it really was ages. Okay, so I'll be back once it is all fixed. Okay, so now it is finally completed. It took a long time and I had to cut quite a bit out. So you just want to seal your bag like I am doing here. And then start with your whipped cream. You want to kind of just show it to the camera. Okay, here I cut it. I don't really know why I did that. Anyway, you want to grab it like you would a piping bag, and then sort of, I released some air, so I had to reopen it, and you might want to do that because you don't want any air in the bag. So then you want to start pushing it down to the edge like you would a normal piping bag. I kept pushing this down to get as much as I could because I didn't want to waste any of it. I squeezed this really hard. Don't get it right to the very tip of the bag, otherwise when you cut it, like I am right here, I wanted to get a really small tip for this. So, yeah, after when you cut it, because it will just come spraying out. So. Here it is, like that is how big this hole is at the moment. I did cut it later, cut it a bit smaller later, but for the time of this video, at the moment, that is how big it was. And it was just because the chunky bits were getting clogged up and I had to cut it more. Anyway, blah blah blah, that is just the size you want it. Then you want to get your cavatrons, I just place them there to get ready to stick in. Okay, so now I am starting to squeeze out the piping or the whipped cream onto the amazing little container, which has a crack in it. So because the hole was so small, there were clumps and it was getting stuck. So I had to cut it again, which I'll be doing soon. Yeah, I go to grab the scissors now, I think. Yeah, no, I'm having a lot of trouble here squeezing it out. Because you do need a hole, because there's a clump, like a big clump, just blocking the space. So it's really hard to cut it. So I cut it a little bit more. And yeah, I just take it out of the picture for a minute. And now it squeezes out a lot easier. And those clumps, do not worry about them, because I get my pencil and I just fix them all up. And I can make it look nice. So that is good. So I like this sort of clumpy effect. If you do not like the clumpy effect, you just want to keep mixing and mixing and mixing. Okay, so I cut it here until I finished it all and I squeezed out lots. And then I just started sticking in my cabochons. I put these on angles, just tried to make them look cute. And I think they're really, really cute. So I'm really happy with how they turned out. So I'm just pressing them in. And I think it looks super cute. So now you just wanna leave it to dry. So I decided here I might stick in another one, but then I decided not to because I didn't like how it looked. So, there you have it. Okay, now it is dry. This is what it looks like. I'm so happy with how it turned out. Okay, if you guys want more Decoden tutorials, give this one a thumbs up. Like, comment, subscribe, all that nice stuff. I'm just so happy with how this turned out, and it looks really nice, I think. And from the time of filming to the time of doing this voiceover, I've actually added a little bit more Decoden to it, so it's actually a lot thicker now and it looks a lot cuter. And it kind of looks like a snow mountain now. So if you guys enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up, like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye!